So, tomorrow is Memorial Day. And, which of course gets you to thinking about remembering things. And, you know, we as a country want to remember those who have, you know, paid the price so that we might be free. But memorials aren't just, I mean, it isn't any new convention for us, for people, for mankind. Memorials are something that have existed as long as there were people. If we look back, God gave a memorial right after the flood, whenever the waters subsided, and then we just had 8 people alive on the planet with a handful of animals. Whenever they came out of the ark, God says, I'm going to make a covenant to you. And He put a rainbow in the sky. So, and He said, this is my promise to you that I am not going to come in war against the world again by rain. And it's a good thing. I mean, I don't see a rainbow right now, but it's a good thing that we have that promise, or else I'd be kind of worried. But God gave this memorial, a memorial of a rainbow, so that every time we see it, we know that He's still faithful to His promises. Whenever He'd brought Israel out of Egypt, brought them to Himself, called them His people, gave them a law, told them He was going to give them a land to live in, and then there was that 40-year hiatus because they were disobedient to God and didn't want to go into the promised land. So whenever they came back after that 40 years, in Deuteronomy chapter 6, right before they're going to go in, Moses talks to the people again. And in chapter 6, starting in verse 6, he says, these words which I am commanding you today shall be on your heart. And those words are about obeying God. You've seen what happens whenever you didn't obey God. Now, I want you to put these words on your heart. Verse 7, you shall teach them diligently to your sons, and you shall talk about them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontals on your forehead. You'll write them on your doorpost of your house, and on your gates. And he goes on to say, then whenever you come into the land that you get all these things that God has given you, you'll fear and worship God only. And so, in a way, this is a memorial. Our actions, as we walk along with our children and teach them about God, as we talk about things with our families and those around us, that is a memorial. Not only that, he says, you're going to write or bind them on your hands so that you can see them. You're going to put them as labels on your forehead. You're going to put them on the doorpost of your house so that no matter where you go, no matter what's around you, you're always surrounded by God's Word and a reminder that God is good and He fulfills His promises. The promise specifically then was that God was going to give them a great land that they could live in. And you remember that. So God put a rainbow in the sky so that we could remember that He's not going to destroy the world by water again. Moses encourages the people to surround themselves with the law of God so that they can remember His promises and that they are His people. You know, and a little bit later, there's this conflict in the land of Canaan whenever the tribes of Israel split up the land of Canaan, some of them didn't want to go across the River Jordan. They wanted to stay in the land on the east side of the Jordan. Well, as time went on, they decided, we're going to build an altar on this side of the river so that the people on the other side will see our altar, that it's the same kind of altar that you got over there, and they won't let the river divide us. Well, what ends up happening is the people over on the western side think that the people on the eastern side have lost their minds. They flipped their lid and they're no longer faithful to God. And so they're coming up to make war against them. And so whenever they got together, they had a little peace talk and things got hammered out. And they were saying, listen, we're building this here so that you can remember that we're a part of you. We have this to remind us and to remind you that we're part of the same family. So, you know, God gave a memorial. Moses gives the people the words of God as a memorial. And even the people, because it's so important to remember who they are in the eyes of God, in the family of God, they wanted to make sure they built something so that they could be reminded of their unity as a family. You know, if we go forward a little bit, that was some Old Testament stuff. But in the New Testament, those same things are true. Peter, over in 2 Peter chapter 1, he says, well, let me turn there. 2 Peter chapter 1, starting in verse 12. Now, this is coming out of Peter's encouragement to Christians to keep growing in their faith, you know, to add to their faith moral excellence and moral excellent knowledge and knowledge, self-control and self-control, perseverance and godliness and brotherly kindness and love. And he says that if you have these things and they're in increasing amount, you're going to be useful and fruitful within the kingdom of God. And that if you don't keep growing, then what's going to happen is you're going to become blind or short-sighted, forgetting that you were purified of your sins. Now, based on that, Peter says, down in verse 12, therefore, I will always be ready to remind you of these things, even though you already know them and have been established in the truth which is present with you. So Peter says, these things are so important. Our growing in faith, in the promises of God and who He is, our growing in that is so important that even though you know it, even though you've been saved by it and you're established in it, I'm still going to be reminding you of these things. Matter of fact, if that's not enough, he goes on in verse 13 and says, I consider it right, as long as I'm in this earthly dwelling, to stir you up by way of reminder. To stir you up. not only am I going to remind you, not only am I going to remind you, but if you could imagine for a moment, whenever I was a kid, we used to get Kool-Aid. We'd come in these little bitty packets. Cherry was my favorite. And so you would take that little packet and you'd get you a pitcher of water. You'd rip open the top and you'd pour that powder, that powdery goodness. Really, I guess it was just all colored sugar, but you pour it in there in your water, and it really doesn't do much. You can see it filtering down, but then as soon as you start to stir it up, that water goes from clear to being red, and then all of a sudden here's this wonderful drink that you could drink on your on a warm summer day like today. Anyway, you take something that's added to, and then whenever you stir it around, it permeates every part of the water. You get what I'm saying? As you stir up whatever is inside of this water, it then rises and it fills the whole thing. And so Peter is saying here, I consider it right to stir you up with reminder. Reminder is the spoon, and I'm going to stir and stir and stir and stir so that you don't forget who you are and you don't forget to keep growing in your faith. And then he continues on and he says, knowing that the laying aside of my earthly dwelling is imminent, he's saying, I'm about to die. I'm going to die here soon. Verse 15, and I will also be diligent that at any time after my departure, you will be able to call these things to mind. And Peter penned those words so that we could be stirred up by him by reading the Bible, by reading his letter that he wrote to us, to Christians, that we are to be living and growing in the godliness that God is providing, that we are to be living and growing in the salvation that he has promised and provided, that we are to be living and growing in our faith all the way down through our love towards one another. And God gave another memorial. Jesus did. We're going to talk about it here in just a few minutes. The memorial that bought us. Just like those people in the Old Testament who made that altar to say, hey, listen, we're family. And I want you to be able to remember that we are family. Jesus, during the Passover, which itself was a memorial that God had brought Israel out of slavery, right? He changes that memorial and makes it about saving you and me with his giving over of his body and by shedding his blood. And he says, this bread and this cup, when you take it, I want you to remember me. Remember your big brother who took the hit for you, who took the hit for me, because he loved us so much. And he brings us all into a family. Scripture speaks of it as that he has bought for himself a people, a kingdom, ready to do good things. And as we're coming to this, Memorial Day weekend, which a lot of people want to go out and celebrate a day off. I want you to know that memorials are good. Memorials are good. But they're not just a day off, right? There's more behind it. Just like our bread and cup, it isn't just a piece of cracker and a little bit of grape juice. There is meaning behind it that is attached to those emblems. And just like Peter gives us a little bit of the Word of God that we can be reminded, it isn't the entirety of life, right? It's a reminder that we are to do these things. It's a reminder of who we are and who we are to be with one another. It's a reminder of God's loving promises to us. It's a reminder of Jesus' sacrifice and His efforts to us, for us. And it's a reminder of who we are to be for God and for one another. And even for the world. Because there's another reminder. And this is one. You might say, Bill, you're stretching a little bit, but okay. Give me some latitude. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, in verse 19, I know we're coming in the middle of a phrase, but it said, God was in Christ reconciling the world to Himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and He has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Therefore, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were making an appeal through us. We beg you, on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. He made Him who knew no sin to be sin on our behalf, so that we, get this, so that we might become the righteousness of God. We, God's people, are a reminder to the world that God is righteous, that God is faithful, that God loves the world and wants to save it. And so our plea is from God through us to the world. Be reconciled. Be part of this family. And we, even though God has given us reminders, reminding us who we are, we are God's reminder to the world. We are God's reminder to the world that He keeps His promises and that He is righteous. And that's what we wear as we proclaim Jesus and we tell folks, won't you be reconciled to God? He has done all this for you. Come to Him. Thank you for being a reminder to me of who I'm supposed to be. I hope that I'm a reminder to you as well. I hope we remind each other. And this Memorial Week, even though it's a national holiday we celebrate, how about let's remind each other? Get on your phone or your Facebook or email or whatever, whatever it is that you do to communicate with your brothers and sisters, and remind them something good about God. Do that this week. I thank you for your time and thank you for being here.